I attended the event this evening because I was invited by Aaron Williams and Lisette Dennis to present the awards to the seventh graders. They described the program, and it struck me as something very worthy and a lot of fun. I was very impressed by the quality of the poems that I heard. I wouldn't say that these are good poems for seventh graders. I would say some of them were very good for poets of any age. My familiarity with the Seventh Grade Poetry Foundation is very limited. Until a few weeks ago, I had never heard of it. And then when I was asked to be the presenter for the program this evening, it struck me as something worth doing, but I have to admit that I still don't know a whole lot about it other than through the results that it produced. I guess if you judge an activity by what it produces, I saw 26 very talented young poets in the room today, and somehow it was able to unlock this talent. So I know, at least from that little window I have, that they're doing a great job. From the winners, it seems that the opportunity of discovering this talent in themselves was very interesting to observe. My guess is that a lot of the students had sentiments, but they were somewhat inchoate, and then being asked to write poems about them allowed them to express it. So my guess is that the winners tonight have a lot more self-confidence than they did before they got into the program, and I think this is an important step on their road to maturity. I think that the influence of the seventh grade poetry program on the community can be nothing but positive. From what I gather, this is one of the most successful programs in the country, and it's just going, success is going to beget more success. I think that as some students see what their counterparts in other schools are doing, or as teachers in some schools see what's happening at other schools, it's going to be contagious, and I think the effect is going to be spectacular. I think that the seventh grade poetry program will certainly have a positive effect on the students who participate, because this is an area where they're able to excel. And we know that it's important to find something you're good at doing, and perhaps they might not be good in some sports or some other activities, but this is, allows them to, I guess, showcase what they can do. I would think that it will create respect on the part of some of their classmates who might not have thought much about poetry, but they see that the fact that their peers show talent in poetry earns them respect. And my guess is it's going to make students who might not have been interested in poetry before want to get involved. I'm 63 years old, so my experience with poetry began probably 60 years ago, and I don't know how you would sum it up in one word. I guess what I've learned from it, there really isn't a defined line between poetry and the rest of life. If you look and listen carefully, you can hear and see poetry in everything. And I don't know that it's if I leave a poetry reading and then, you know, the poetry hat goes off and the normal life hat goes on. I think poetry is just part of our life, and you just focus more on that part of life while you're specifically listening to poetry or writing it. Well, I would say in some ways being a presenter for this seventh grade poetry awards ceremony was coming back to a former career, because before I went to law school I taught 8th, 9th, and 10th grade English, and that's a side of my life that has been neglected for 34 years, and coming back and being in a room with these talented young people reading their poems made me recall my inner teacher.